In Microsoft Excel, if you don't need to see certain columns and rows for the time, or if you need to print your worksheet but don't want a few columns or rows in the printing, then you can hide those columns and rows instead of deleting them. Hiding columns and rows preserve the data within them, and the formulas used in those columns or rows will still be functional. For instance, let's see print preview of this worksheet. As you can see that all the records are fitted properly on page according to page length. But a few columns are getting extended to second page. I don't want a few columns to be printed. Like this province column, I don't want to print this column, so what I do is, I select this column and then click Format under Cell section of Home tab. Then point to Hide and Unhide, and then click Hide Columns. The another quick way to hide a column is to use right-click context menu. For example, I don't want this discount column either, so I right-click on column G, and then click Hide. You can follow the same procedure to hide specific rows in your worksheet. For example, I don't need to see or print this fifth record of customer name Carlos. So to hide this entire row, I can either select the row first, then click Format, then Hide and Unhide, and choose Hide Rows. Or I can directly right-click on that particular row and choose Hide from the context menu. If you want to select and hide more than one column or row in a time, then what you only need to do is to select multiple columns and rows at once, then use the Hide Columns or Rows command respectively. But what if the columns or rows that you want hide are not in continuous order? To select non-continuous multiple columns and rows, you can use the Control key. For instance, if I need to hide order ID and ship date columns, what I do is, I select the column B first, then press and hold the Control key, and then click ship date column. The same method goes with rows. Select the first row, then press and hold down the Control key, then start selecting other non-continuous rows. When you need to unhide a column, you first need to select the left and right columns, alongside the hidden column. Like, if I need to unhide the column K, then I will first select the column J and L, then right-click and choose Unhide. In Excel 2016, there is a quick way to unhide columns or rows as well. Even though you can identify the hidden columns and rows by their column headings and row numbers, but when you hide a column or row, you can also see a little gap between the columns and rows headings. This gap indicates about the hidden columns or rows. So, if you double-click the border, instantly the hidden columns or rows will be visible. If any time you feel that you need to unhide all the columns or rows in your worksheet, then clicking the button on upper left corner of your worksheet will select the entire worksheet. Then right-click on any column heading, and then choose Unhide, and this will unhide all the columns in this worksheet. You can do exactly the same to unhide all the hidden rows as well. Select the entire worksheet, then right-click on one of the rows heading, and choose Unhide. So you can hide or unhide columns and rows for both visual and printing purposes. Hope you will like this video. Tell us by hitting the thumbs up button and leaving a comment. Don't forget to share this video with your friends. Subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos.